I am a price matcher and a couponer and a budgeter. And so when I was asked where I wanted to die, I said hospice. It wasn't a thought. I said hospice. And so that was fine. And the person who had asked me said, why? And I said, well, it's my understanding that if you die in a home, it can affect the resale of the house. And I don't want my husband to have to deal with explaining to the realtor that his wife died and that it's going to affect the resale of the house. So I thought, I'm going to die in hospice. It's then my husband can come home and it's not the spot where I had just taken my last breath. It will hopefully increase his resale. And it's also kind of a neutral ground where family and friends can come and they're not feeling like they're imposing. My husband can come home. He has a bit of a retreat from the hospital, and I die in a hospital or hospice residence setting that is just kind of separated from his life. I can appreciate wanting to die at home. I think I made a lot of decisions well before I was ever sick, that I just made assumptions, not decisions, but assumptions. And then now that I'm going through it, I've just changed my mind that for me, if there's a space, I would like to be in a hospice residence because it's so serene and you're going to get the absolute best care. And the thought of Keith or my husband having to constantly be on call and does this mean that and should I call now and who do I notify that she just took three breaths instead of two or whatever, is just, I don't want to put them through that. So for me, I've currently made the decision of being in hospice residence, but it might change, but for right now that's the decision.